Here is now a list, an incomplete, of other C++11 features shortly mentioned. So there is now default constructors that can be added, and you can delete certain constructors in classes. You can use extern templates, which allows you the separation of declaration and the definition of templates. Remember, we always had to put the templates into the header file. This can now be changed. It prevents the instantiation of a template in a translation unit. So when you say, for example, extend template class vector, and then this is basically my class, which is a template parameter, it means that the compiler knows, okay, this specific class has been instantiated and is defined somewhere else. What does delegating constructor calls mean? It allows you to call other constructors. There is a new type of constructors, which is called move constructor, which allows you to move variables in memory rather than copy them. So you try to move the ownership instead of copying them, because that is a performance improvement. It's not easy to use, so to be said. I think it's more, but it substitutes and extends our idea of a copy constructor. Yeah, a move constructor is similar to copy constructor, but rather moves memory instead of copying it. There's also a regular expression library. We have attributes, which are similar to pre-compiler directives, but a bit more powerful. It's now a standard syntax for implementation-defined language extensions. For example, here we see in the double brackets, it should use for a C compiler this optimization level 1 and debug flags. This is standardized to some extent what kind of attributes you can set. So there's also now a terminology for inheritance. We can declare a class as a method to be override. That indicates that we aim to override this existing function. So this obviously only makes sense when you have a virtual function. So here I have a virtual sum func, and I say override. That means that should I plan that classes shall override it. Lastly, I can say final to a method, which means I cannot override this method anymore by subsequent children of this class. There is now a type-safe replacement for null, for a pointer, and this is called null pointer. So you can set, instead of saying int star a equals 0, or null that you know from C, you can use null pointer. This is type-safe. That means the compiler can do certain checks that it's assigned properly. There's now support for Unicode strings that replace ASCII. So you can use UTF-8, UTF-16, or UTF-32 character encodings. Random number generation is also supported. Check out this link to get further information about C++11 features. Now talking about C++14. So what we can do is now we can try to deduce from a function what type it returns. So we can now create a function sumfunc, and we say the return type is auto. Yeah, so it means the compiler tries to infer the return type. How does it do it work in this case? Well, here we return 5. So the compiler knows this is an integer type, this kind of expression. So that means the type will be of type integer. I personally find this obfuscates the meaning of the code. But if you create a support function or a lambda function, this can be helpful. Now you can also define in binary the literal, so you can define the individual bits of an integer. So I can say var1 is 0b, that indicates it's in binary, and then I can define the different bits of this integer. There is some more concepts of lambda, so lambdas are more extended now with more capabilities to do what they are supposed to do, I would say. And there were mostly fixes and minor extensions to C++11 features, and you find here more details. ISOCPP.org, ISO is the standard, and CPP, well, C++. So recent standards are C++17. You can find here on Stack Overflow more information. What are the features? They are minor, I'd say. They are not in all compilers yet. That's why I wouldn't include them here. In C++20, Yeah, it's not yet. Maybe it is now. Well, it was not yet decided for the final standard. I have to check it.